The Gemara and Daf Chaf Gimel discusses all of the different ways we know that Chametz B'Pesach is Aser Banah. So to review them quickly, we have Chizki Yeshita who holds Evi Lo Yeyachel, means an Iser Hanah. And today we learn in the Gemara that Chizki knew that from the Parsha of Shrotzim, where the Torah uses the word Lo Yeyachel, and the Torah says Lachem, to tell us that it's Mutar Banah, so that's how he knew that wherever it says lo yeyachel by itself, it means an iser hanah, such as by chametz bePesach. Then we have Rabbi Vo, who says any loshen iser achila automatically means an iser hanah, and he knew that from nevela and from the fact that the Torah had to tell us that nevela is mutter to sell to a goy. Rabbi Yehuda says you wouldn't be able to know that from nevela because nevela, the Torah has a special message when it tells us to sell to a goy and to gift to a ger. So Rabbi Yehuda, according to Rabbi Vo, knows that all Lashon Achilos mean Iser Hanah from the fact that the Torah says by the Parsha of Trefa, La Kelev Tashlichun Oisoi, only Trefa is mutter to throw to your dog and have Hanah from, even though it says Lo Yoichal, but all other places in the Torah where it says Lo Yoichal, it would be Aser Banah. That Oisoi, we have to darshan. If you don't learn like Rabbi Yehuda, that Oysa is teaching you that Evi lo yochal is Iser Achila, what is Oysa used for? So the Gemara says that all the other Shitas will learn that the Oysa is used to teach us that Chulun Shenishchutu Ba'azara is Osa Midaraisa. But the way Rabbi Vo learns, according to Rabbi Yehuda, Chulun Shenishchutu Ba'azara is not Dairaisa. So at the end of the day, the only difference between Rabbi Vohu and Chizkiah's approach to the Iser Hanah by Chametz is whether or not Chulin Shenishchutu Ba'azara, according to Rav Yehuda, is Dairaisa or not. We actually was introduced to a fourth Shita by a Hahumei Rabbanan, who rejected both the Chizkiah's understanding of Lo Yeyachel as well as Rabbi Vo, both according to Rav Yehuda and according to Rav Meir. And he came up with a new Svara, and he brought a pasuk that it says, when you spritz the blood of a Korban Chatos that was supposed to be spritzed on the outside of the Mizbeach, when you spritz it on the inside Mizbeach, the Torah says, Lo Yeyachal, and then it says, Ba'esh Tisarif. So that Ba'esh Tisarif is extra, because we already know from other psukim that such blood, such a carbon would have to be burnt if the blood was spritzed in the wrong place. So we apply that Ba'esh Tisarif to every other place in the Torah, where it says, an Iser Achila, that there will be an Iser Hanah. There's no Chiyuv Sreifa there, because it's Dafka B'Kodesh, the Gemara says. So at the end of the day, we have four Mekoyers, four reasons why there's an Iser Hanah by Chametz B'Pesach. Now the Gemara then goes through a whole bunch of different psukim that have the word Lo Yoichal or Lo Yeyachel and explain that there's a special reason in each pasuk why there's no Iser Hanah there. So the Gemara asks from Truma and from Yain Lenazir and from Chodosh and from Shrotzim. And these were all cases where the Torah says Lo Yoichal or Lo Yeyachel, and they all have special limudim to teach us that they are in fact Mutar B'Hanah. We also got into a little bit of a shaila of having a Noah doing business with Isurei Achila, such as Shrotzim, Ramashim. So Tosfos tells us that the only Isser is if you're dealing with food products that you eat. But if you're dealing with animal byproducts that are not kosher, that are not made to eat, such as hides or oils, there you would be allowed to deal with those things in business. Then the Gemara brought a mechloikis between Rabbi Akiva and Rabbi Shaglili, when the Torah tells us by the chelav of a nevela that it's mutter yasa l'chol melacha, is it teaching us a chiddush in tuma tahira, or is it teaching us a chiddush in iser hanah? The Gemara ended up saying that the machloikis between them is everybody agrees that achila means iser hanah. The only machloikis is when the Torah was mater nevela v'hanah, did it mean to include only the basher nevela or all of the other edible parts that are with it as well? And therefore, if it included all the edible parts, it would automatically include for the chelev and the git as well. But if not, then it wouldn't. So according to Rabbi Yosef Glili, who the Gemara said that when the Torah was matter, nevela b'hanah, it did not include chelev and it did not include gid, Yet we have a special pasuk, Yasalach HaMalacha, to tell you that Chelev is Mutibana, the Chelev of an Avela. How would he know that the Gid of an Avela is Mutibana? So in fact, Gemara offers one option, that Rabbi Yosef Glil holds like Rabbi Shimon, that a Gid Anasa is Aserbana. But there was another approach that he has a Kavachomer, Mad Chelev, which is an Isser Karis if you eat it. Nevertheless, it's Mutibana if it's from an Avela. So too, or Kol Shegein, Gid Anasha, which is only an Isser Lav, it should surely be Aser Bana. The other one, Damar Mahold, you don't have a Raya, because Chelev is a Kula that doesn't apply to Chayis, while Rabbi Yosef Glil says, we'll focus only on Behemoth, and by Behemoth, Chelev is surely more Chomer than Gid, and if Chelev is Mutar Bana, surely a Gid should be Mutar Bana.